Please help me.
Are you okay, Daddy? Do you need help?
I'm gonna get my friend Bumble.
Looks like we have another street popper. Well, I guess we better get her inside.
That woman's with child. Hurry, hurry.
So what happened?
The poor girl died, but she gave birth to a healthy baby boy.
What's that you've got there?
It's an expensive looking gold pocket watch. It was all the mother had on her. I was going to save it for the young boy when he became of age.
Absolutely not. We'll make a nice wedding gift for my fiance.
But it might provide us information who his relatives are.
No one's ever gonna come looking for this boy.
What will you name the boy?
Well, I usually do these things alphabetically. The last one was an F, it was Smythe. This time it should be a T. How about Twist? Oliver Twist.
Oliver Twist. That's a nice name. I'll go put it on his birth record.
And don't forget to put Mother Unknown.
Yes, sir.
Oh boy, finally old enough to go to the workhouse.
Mr. Bumble.
For what you are about to receive, may the Lord make you thankful.
Amen.
Will you relax and sit down?
I can't relax. If I don't get any more food, I might have to eat the lad who sleeps next to me.
Mr. Pastor!
Alright, Oliver. It's time. Just like I told you. Remember, don't back down. We're here for you, mate.
Please, sir, may I have some more?
What did you say?
Please, sir, may I have some more?
Well, you ungrateful little brat! I'll teach you that! More!
What?
More food?
That's uncalled for.
We need to get rid of him.
He must take him out.
He must leave.
Get out!
That boy will be hanged someday.
Get that little street urchin out of here.
Hope we find a buyer for that brat.
I don't want to ever see you come back.
Ah, Oliver. Welcome to our home.
He's rather small.
Don't worry, he'll grow.
I just hope he doesn't eat more than he costs.
But he's got such a somber look. I think he'd make a great mew for children's funerals.
Well, Oliver, we've already eaten, and I'm not cooking again. So would you mind eating the scraps that the dog left behind? Well, are you finished?
Come on, boy. I want Noah to teach you how to do your job right. It's time for you to meet him. This way.
Charlotte, Noah, I'd like you to meet Oliver Twist.
Oliver's going to be an apprentice for us, Noah. I hope he's a good one. So I want you to make sure that he knows everything about the business to do the best work he can for our family.
Oh, I'll make sure he knows everything about the funeral business.
And if he messes up, tell me.
So what brings you here, Workus? The circus throw you out? What, cat got your tongue? Or is it just a rat? What kind of critters you got living in that dirty old hair of yours?
Hi, kids. How's your lunch? Mm-hmm. No, you did a really good job on the coffee this morning. You should be proud of us. Oliver, your work was sloppy. You need to get in that house in 5 minutes.
Now you've done it, Workus. It'll be doggy food for you tonight. But I'm sure you're used to that, since that's all your poor, dirty old mummy could afford.
Don't you dare talk about my mother like that.
Good. So now I've got your attention. Poor, jolly old Workus. His dirty mother left him for the baddies.
I'm warning you.
Your mother never loved you. No one ever has. I can see it in your rosy cheeks. I bet ever since you were born, she was just looking for a way to get rid of you. And you know what the worst part about it is? Nobody cares. No one cares if you live or die. If you die, there'll be no one to cry over you. Not even your dirty, rotten mother.
That's it.
No!
Stop it! Get off of him!
Go get Mr. Bumble! You rotten little boy!
He hit me! He hit me! He's a savage! You have to send him back to the Workus!
Don't worry, lad. I'll make sure he wish he'd never seen me. Where is the boy?
He's in the cellar, sir. We got him locked up as soon as we could.
You better see to it that he's put in some good institution, because we don't need street rats like him hanging around this neighborhood. If you don't get him out of here, I'm going to lock him in a coffin, and he's going to stay in there till Europe sinks to the bottom of the sea.
Darn right I'll put him in a loony house, going around hurting people's loved ones like they've done something wrong to him. But seriously, can you let him out? I got to get something elsewhere.
You heard the man. Let him out.
Oliver, get up here. It's time for your punishment, you hear? Oh, you filthy little boy. I'll come down there and teach you a lesson.
He's gone. Just gone. What are we going to do now?
What do you mean he's gone? Where could he have gone?
You didn't check on him last night before I got here? You know, the workhouse is quite a ways away, and there's no transportation, so I had to run all the way over here. It's the only way I can make
it. Well, I mean, how could he have escaped? The window's always locked.
I gotta go check that window. I'll be right back. Mr. Rumble. Oh, get yourself together, woman. The lock on the window is broken. He must have gotten out that way, but at least he's gone and he's never coming back. Oh, by the way, I'd like my money back.
Get your apples over here. Apples. Apples. Two shillings.
Come get your fresh bread today.
Apples. Apples over here. Hello.
Fresh bread. Come and get your fresh bread today. 3 shillings.
Two shillings.
Fresh bread.
Ripe apples. Good day to you. Apples, two shillings.
Hey,
get
them!
Apples, 2 shillings. Get your apples over here. Apples, two shillings. Today, sir.
Fresh bread, anyone?
3 shillings. Fresh bread, anyone? Thank you, sir. Good day. Apples, 2 shillings.
Fresh bread, anyone? Fresh bread.
Get your apples over here.
Trying to be friendly. I sees you lying there and I said to myself, now Dodger, if that was you lying there in that right dirty and disgusting state, wouldn't you want some nice clean gentleman like yourself to come and pick you up? Or just leave you there for the rats? And I said to myself, I says, no, not for all the shins in the world I wouldn't. So I comes back and I saves you. What? You got some sort of a staring problem or something? Do I look funny to you, mate?
No, sir.
Sir, what's this with calling a book, sir? There's only one my father called, sir, and I did away with him a long time ago.
I'm sorry, did you say did away with?
Oh, now he speaks English. Ain't none of your business, mate. You just just be glad I saved you. Now you must be very hungry. You don't look like you've had victuals in a month.
Oh yes, I'm very hungry. I've been walking for 7 days.
7 days? Walking for 7 days?
Oh, I see.
Big order, eh? But I suppose you don't know what a beak is, my flash companion.
You mean a bird's beak?
My eyes, how green. Oh, your beak's a magistrate. When you walk past the beak's order, it's never straightforward. But always a going up and never a coming down again. Was you ever in the mill?
What mill?
What mill, he says. What mill? Why, the mill. The mill is so filled with people, they can fill it quite a stone jug. And it's better when the wind's low with people. When it's high. Because I can't find workmen. But come. You want grub and you shall have it. Come on your pins.
Apples.
Going to London?
Yes.
Got any lodgings?
No.
Money?
No.
Apples.
Do you live in London?
I do when I'm at home. I suppose you'd be wanting a place to stay for tonight.
Oh, yes, apples. I haven't slept on the roof since I left the country.
Well, don't fret your islands on that score. It just so happens I have to be in London tonight due to strict business matters. And I know a spectacle old gentleman that'll give you will give you lodgings for nothing and never ask you for the change. Just as long as some gentleman he knows introduces you. And don't he know me? Oh, no, not in the least.
Well, who did you say you were again?
I was wondering when that particular thought would burst through your brain. The name's Dawkins. Jack Dawkins. Well, my mates, they call me Dodger, the Artful. The Artful Dodger, if you like. I'm a man of my business, and I'm good at what I do. In fact, I was out on business today when you ran into me. You could say that I took my slight chances of getting slammed by the bosses to come and pick you up. But no matter. I'm sure he'll be happy with me when he sees I bought him you.
Apples.
Fresh bread.
Here he is, Fagin, my good friend Oliver Twist.
Ah, yes. Oliver, very pleased to meet you. Very. Charlie, lay off the sausages. Draw a tub near the fire for Oliver. Ah, you're staring at the pocket handkerchiefs. Hey, my dear, they're a good bunch, ain't they? We just looked them up, ready for the wash, that's all.
Here you go, Oliver, some good Easter's leg I promised you.
Drink up, my dear, it'll help you sleep. I expect you'll be needing a bit of shut-eye. Hey? Yes, Doctor told me all about your long journey. But you tell me. How does a chap like yourself, with no parents, come all the way to London when there's nothing even here for him?
Well, Mr. Fagin, sir...
Oh, no need for sir, my dear. We're all family here. Just call me Fagin.
Well, Fagin, I was born in a workhouse.
Oh, shh. Don't hurt yourself, my dear. Off to bed with ya.
Man, that hurt!
Let him sleep. I didn't see you making it that far. Now, Oliver, we'll start you out with a simple task. See if you can take this out of my pocket without me knowing.
Not like that. It's too obvious. You'll get in trouble with the beaks for that one. Come on, give it another go.
Fine, gonna try again. Very well, my dear.
The new bakery today. They had some good pastries, but they did have quite a ruckus in some of Fagin's voice music.
I'm really worried about Bill. He's out really late doing that new job for Fagin.
I wish you didn't have to deal with Fagin. I wish you could have a better life.
I need you to go to Fagan's and get the money from the last job.
Can it wait? I'm talking to Beth.
No, I want you to go now. And when you get back, fix me some supper.
Well, buddies, we had a very good income today. But I'm expecting even more tomorrow.
Hey, Fagan, let's show all over the game.
Ah, yes, yes, the game. Oliver, would you like to make a handkerchief?
Do it. Sure.
Well, come on then, you heard the boy. Let's show him how it's done.
You're goofy.
What'd you expect, Fagan? We're pros.
Well, we're getting again, are we, Fagan? Well, we're just showing you more about how it's done.
Beth, Nancy.
Hi, boys. How have you been feeling today?
Yes, went quite well.
Who's the new one?
Well, that's Oliver. Oliver Twist.
That's pitiful. It's like a Queen of England. Don't pay no attention to them. You've got manners that they ain't.
Come on, boys. Let's go play a match around the pool.
Fagan, Bill is really mad. You still owe him money.
Well, what do you want me to do? I mean, the boys and I will just live off the air for the time being.
Fagan, this isn't funny. You know how Bill is.
Well, Dodger, go on now. This doesn't concern you. Tell Bill that I'm working on getting his money and that he just needs to calm down.
If he has to come get it in the morning, you'll end up in the bottom of a river. Come on, Beth.
Now, just a matter of time before the beaks get him. I'm the reason why he's living!
Apples! Fresh baked
apples! Lovely morning.
Mm-hmm. Baby red apples!
Mr. Brownlow, how are you doing, sir? Top of the morning.
Two.
What do you think? How much for the hat, sir?
30 shillings.
I don't know, though. What do you think? Does this look good on me or anything? Doesn't really fit. I'm sorry.
Good idea, sir.
Okay, son?
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
Sure. You're okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Hat. Hat's over here.
How much do you have?
My money's been stolen. You little street chance. Come back here.
So, Fagan, when am I going to be able to go out and get some work done with everybody else?
Well, I suppose you do need to practice.
Where's my money, Fagan?
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have it.
What's behind your back?
Well, this is nothing.
So who's the new kid?
Well, this is Oliver. Oliver Twist.
You know you're short here.
Well, Oliver can help you with whatever you need done.
Yeah, you'll come in handy. I need a little guy to get me through the windows on some of my burglaries.
Yes, son. I'll keep his schedule open.
You do that, Fagan. And don't be short again.
This is a good one.
No, it's okay.
I really recommend this one.
That's all right. I think I'll take it.
So what are we doing in a bookstore?
Well, Oliver, there always seems to be rich folks in here wanting to contribute to our cause.
This will be an easy one, boys. Let's go get them.
Well, me and my friend here, seeing as how you seem to be the literary type, thought you wouldn't mind, you know, showing us a few books that might be of our interest.
Please, sir. Well, I loved this book when I was a child. It's just amazing.
I also like this novel. The characters are great in it. This book was good too. This book would probably be good for your age. It may be a little hard, but it's a nice book. This one is also great.
Well, thank you, sir.
That could be very helpful for us.
Stop there! Sir, you've just been robbed. That boy has your book.
He did it.
They're heading towards the courtyard. Go!
Stop by the guy.
It wasn't me!
Officers! Mr. Ballard's just been robbed!
Let's go! Let's go!
Did you see where the thief went?
He went out. Oh,
forget it. Follow me.
There he is!
Stop thief!
And alive for you. You're going to the gallows.
Straight to jail with you.
Mr. Brownlow, is this little rascal that robbed you?
Is it, sir?
Yes, that is the little brat.
That little mongrel, all right.
I'm innocent. No, don't.
You're off to the judge for you.
Let's go. I'm innocent.
Dirty scoundrel, let's go.
Uh-oh, they got Oliver. What are we going to tell Fagin?
What are we going to tell Fagin? It's your fault. Why don't you tell him?
It's his fault.
No, it's your fault.
No, it's your fault.
Uh-oh, they're coming.
Stand still, you little thief.
Don't move.
Quiet.
Deserve
quiet.
Everybody get here. Go right down.
I said I want quiet in my courtroom, now! Now, I haven't got all day. What seems to be the issue, sir?
Your Honor, this boy stole from my good friend and customer, Mr. Brownlow, as he was doing his daily shopping.
Do you have any proof of this, mister?
Yes, Your Honor, I do. Had his filthy hands all over. Stole it right from Mr. Brownlow's hands, he did. Saw it with my own two eyes.
Is this true, Mr. Brownlow?
Why, yes it is, Your Honor, but...
Well then, what do you suppose we do, mister?
I propose we dispose of this thing. Some to a chimney sweep, manual labor. Sounds good to me. Sounds like a fair sentence.
Well, all right. But it really is Mr. Brownlow's choice. And, my good sir, Mr. Brownlow, are you in agreement with your companion to sell him to a chimney sweep?
I am in agreement, Your Honor.
Well then... Settled.
Please, sir, don't send me away. I won't ever steal ever again in my entire life. I promise.
You swear, boy? Do you swear? What was your name again?
Oliver Twist, sir. Oliver Twist.
All right, Mr. Oliver Twist. I will not agree to send you away, but you will have to come with me so I can make sure you keep your promise. That will be all, Your Honor. Thank you.
You can't let him do that, Your Honor. You just can't. He'll murder him in his sleep. He rids him of everything he owns. He takes everything. And then...
Nobody asked you. Case dismissed.
Come along, Oliver. You're getting a second chance in life. This is your new home, Oliver. You never have to sleep on the streets again.
Oliver, we're so happy you're home.
So, what do you think of this place?
It's the most beautiful place I've ever been in.
Let me go get you some proper clothes, Oliver.
Mrs. Bedwin, will you cook him up a great dinner?
Thank you for letting me live with you.
That's great. So, Oliver, what would you like to do with your life?
I think I'd like to own my own business.
Well, you're turning into quite the gentleman. I think that would be a great idea.
So now the word on the street is that Oliver's been taken in by some old badger named Brownlow. Probably very wealthy, very high up from what I'm hearing. Oliver can't complain. He's probably living in the lap of luxury as we speak.
We never should have taken him in. It's only a matter of time before the little rat lets the cat out of the bag, and we all pay the price. All of us, in prison, put away for life.
Or hang!
Oh, that's just great, Bates. Always looking on the sunny side, aren't we?
Don't chick at me. It's your fault for showing him. You told him to.
My fault, eh?
Boys, now is not the time to be blaming each other for one thing or another. Whosever fault it is doesn't matter anymore. We just need to find out a way to get him back.
And how do you propose we do that, my dear? Just take a little stroll up to Brown Nose's door, knock, and when he asks, we just say, will you please give us our darling little pickpocket pack?
Don't talk to me like that, Fagin. You know I want Oliver back here just as much as you do. However, I view Oliver as a friend. An innocent little boy who doesn't know what he's gotten into. That's the difference between you and me.
And the doctor glanced keenly around when the ring was heard at the gate, and at the same moment, the sound of wheels. It's the runner, cried Brittle, to all appearance, much relieved. The what? Exclaimed the doctor, aghast in his turn. Oliver, how do you like the story so far?
I like it a lot. Thanks for reading it to me, Rose.
Yeah, well, Oliver, I look to you as like a little brother to me now. I'm so glad you're home.
Sorry to break your lovely mood, mates, but I do believe we have a visitor. And forgive me if I'm right, but he doesn't sound at all pleased.
It sucks!
Now we're in for it. Get look at this one, Fagin. I'm out of here.
Come to think of it, me too. I've got some business to do on the west side.
Boys! I mean, you can't just...
Where is he, Fagin? Where's the boy, you bloody old coot?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you mean you don't know what I'm talking about? Where's Oliver?
All right, just put me down! I don't know how to say this, but... He's gone, Bill. He's been taken to a huge manor on the outskirts of the city to live with some filthy rich old man called Brownlow. He was taken to court yesterday afternoon after they caught him for stealing.
It's him then, is it? Dawkins? I'll kill him.
No, you can't blame Dodger. I mean, he's my best man.
Then who do I blame?
I don't know and I don't care. All I know is that I bloody want the boy back.
You want the boy back? I need him.
And you shall have him, Bill. Once we've worked out a plan. And I think when we do have him, we can make it work to our advantage.
How?
Call in the men. I'll tell you how. We'll all be filthy rich.
Well, it looks like I'm gonna lose again. Let's make a wager.
All right.
That Oliver is living with me now. He's such a great kid, and he really respects others.
He's one of those street boys. One of these days, they'll rob you. I wouldn't be surprised in like 10 years if he's hanging from the gallows.
Well, that's not what I catch from my eye.
Mm-hmm. Just wait. One of these days, he'll break your heart.
Oliver, what book are you reading?
A book called The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, sir.
That's a scary book. You better be careful. Make sure it doesn't give you any nightmares.
I will.
Hello, sir. Kid just came by. Dropped the book off for you. Says it's new.
Oh, thank you, but I have two more books to give him.
He's already left. Would you like me to deliver him?
Can I take him?
Yes, you can, but do you know the way?
No.
I'd be happy to show him.
Take him to my office, give him the check, and then show him the way. Thank you.
You just got robbed. If that kid ever comes back, I'll eat my hat.
Brown Nose is very wealthy. He's perfect. Besides, Oliver knows his way around the house.
You genius, Fagin. Pure genius.
He's too attached, old man. We need to find a way to persuade him.
Who said anything about persuasion, you idiot?
Well...
So Oliver down by the marketplace, by the bookstore. What you might want to know.
Perfect. Go get him. Take Nancy, too. He has her trust.
Oh, my dear brother, where have you been? Mother's there so worried about you.
Nancy, what are you doing
where
here?
Where have you been, you little scoundrel? Your mother's worried to death.
Who are you?
Whose books are these?
Go home, Brad.
Mr. Brownlow.
You stole these from Mr. Brownlow?
No, he gave them to me.
Come on, you're
back.
Going back to your mother.
Nancy, give them back. Let go of me.
It's
follow me.
But Nancy, why'd you do it?
I had no choice. Now come on.
What if it isn't a little runaway?
Oliver, you're back. I knew you'd be here.
Here's the books. Bill took the money as payment.
But what does he expect from me to get with books?
But they're Mr. Brownlow's books, and if I don't give them back, he'll think I stole them.
You're with us now, boy.
None of your loyalty. You got it good here, boy.
Well, look at these clothes. They look like something the Queen would wear.
Officer, I'd like to report a missing person. His name is Oliver Twist. He's an orphan that came to live with me. He's about 4'9", brown hair. I'd like you to put up posters around the city to see if you can find him.
All right, yes, we can do that. We'll put posters out a 50-mile radius. We'll also keep an eye on the pickpocket gangs and street gangs. I'll check the warehouse, too.
Thank you so much.
Anytime. Thanks.
Thanks.
Have you seen my gun? I'm going to pick up Oliver, and we're robbing Mr. Brownlow tonight.
Mr. Brownlow? Oliver? Leave that poor little boy alone. You've done enough to him.
It's not your decision. I'm taking Oliver.
No, you're not. You leave him alone. You're not taking him over my dead body.
Yes, I am. And if it comes to that, so be it.
Hello.
I heard you were looking for information on a young orphan named Oliver Twist.
Yes. Come in. I'll take you to Mr. Brownlow.
I know the boy you're seeking. I was present at his birth.
Well, what's his name?
Oliver Twist.
That's the boy I'm looking for. So, tell me what you know.
Well, his mother came to us pregnant. Soon after giving birth, she collapsed and died. Well, how old is the boy? He should be about 10 now. That sounds like our Oliver.
Whatever became of Oliver?
Well, I no longer work there, but I heard that Mr. Bromo kicked him out of the orphanage, and Oliver went on his way to London.
How do you know that this is my Oliver?
Well, when his mother died, I found a gold pocket watch. I was going to give it to him when he got older. But the evil Mr. Bumble that I was working for took it away, and he later gave it to his fiancée as a wedding gift. That evil man.
Mrs. Bedwin, help Miss Sally out the door and fetch her reward. Mr. Giles, find this Mr. Bumble. He's at the workhouse.
Yes, sir.
I hope we can find our Oliver.
I hope we can, too.
I've got a job to pull off, and I need a little man to get us through the window.
Wait, what job?
It doesn't matter. All I know is I need Oliver.
No. Take one of the more experienced ones.
Just shut up, Fagin.
He's not that great. Really? No.
Stop, you're squirming.
No.
Find yourself 6 feet on the ground.
Really? Anyone?
You know, we shouldn't even be here. He's gonna take my nice locket away.
Dear, with the reward we're gonna get from this, I could buy you 10 lockets just as good.
How can I help you?
I hear there's an award for information on a young man named Oliver Twist. On Oliver Twist.
Absolutely, if your information proves to be true. So, tell me what you know.
Well, this young girl came and collapsed at our gate one day, and we carried her in, and she had the baby, and then promptly died.
So, what did she look like?
Well, she was on the shorter side.
She had brown hair.
And a pale complexion.
When was this?
It was...
May 21st.
1824, that was it.
That was the day after my daughter disappeared. Whatever happened to the lad?
Well, he stayed at our orphanage till about a few weeks ago, but then he acted out and we had to remove him. And I sold him off to be an apprentice for a nice man, but he acted out there too and ran away afterwards.
What did he do to cause all this trouble?
He asked for more food.
You threw a child out of your orphanage because he was hungry? What? I should report you.
Well, it's against our policy to ask for more.
What proof do you have that this is the Oliver Twist I'm talking about?
Well,
We have this pocket watch.
And we were going to give it to him when he became of age.
No, you weren't. You just kept it for your own profit. This is the pocket watch I gave my daughter.
Mrs. Bedwin, Mr. Giles, show these evil people out.
I told you we shouldn't have come here.
I'll still be getting my reward, won't I?
Yes, you will. But I'll make sure that you never work for the government again.
This is the house.
I'm not going to help you steal.
You're going to do it, and you're going to keep your mouth shut.
But this is Mr. Brownlow's house. I'm not going to steal from him.
You're going to find us a window to get into. We're not below it.
Get out of here.
Stop, thief!
I think that was Oliver.
I certainly hope it wasn't.
I have to go check on Rose.
You'll be fine. I've been shot before.
What didn't hurt?
I can't believe you fouled this up. All the money, it's gone. And what if they saw your face? Now they're gonna be looking for us. Maybe we should just take him to the river now and drown him.
No, not right now. Let's save him to Fagin's. I don't know what to do.
Come on, let's go.
What are we gonna do with Oliver? He foiled the robbery and now everyone knows who we are.
Brownlow's is old. He won't know what to do.
We have to kill Oliver.
I'm taking him to the river tonight.
No, let's take him right now.
No. The beaks are out more than ever. Besides, give him a few days to see if he'll go anywhere. And he's hurt. It doesn't matter. He's really not going anywhere. He's injured.
Okay, but if he shows any sign of bolting, then I'm coming back and drowning him. Where's Nancy? Come on!
Yes?
I need to speak to Mr. Brownlow.
Why? He's very busy right now.
It's about the boy.
Oliver Twist? You have information on Oliver Twist.
Yes, Oliver Twist. And his life is in great danger.
Come on in.
I've got information about the boy, Oliver. His life is in great danger, but I can't talk right now. Someone might be watching.
So, where can we meet then?
Tomorrow night at midnight. At the bridge.
All right, I'll meet you there, but can I go to the...
No, I've already endangered my life by coming here. Just meet me at the bridge tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm really worried about Oliver. I overheard Bill, Toby, and Fagin talking about killing him.
That's such a shame. He's such a nice boy.
I know, he's so innocent. He's never done anything to anyone.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm going to try to speak to Mr. Brownlow.
Be careful. These are very dangerous people. They've killed people. You know that.
I'm so tired of dealing with Fagin and living a life of crime. If anything should happen to me, go to the police. I'm going tonight.
Be careful.
What are you ladies talking about? Going where?
We were running low on food and I was just going to go to the market to get you some supper.
Good. I'll be hungry when I get back. I have to meet with Toby tonight to make some important decisions.
We have to act fast.
My dear friend, what's the matter?
It's the boy, Mr. Brownlow. He's not safe. I wanted to hand him over to you tonight, but Fagin's got a close eye on him.
Fagin? Who?
He's got him hidden back at the base, but he won't let anyone see him.
Dear God, but how?
Oh, Mr. Brownlow, you've just got to help him. Get the beaks. Scotland Yard. I don't care how you do it. Just get that poor boy out of there.
My dear Miss Nancy, don't you worry about a thing. I think I know what to do. You just get out of here before anyone sees you.
Williams' house. They do have that back door.
Fagin, I need to talk to you.
Well, what is it, dear?
I need to talk to you in private. Something.
Well, anything that you need to say, you can say for the bill.
Well, I was out doing my job, just like you told me to.
Yes.
Nancy.
Come on, say it.
She's walking, and she gets to a bridge, and Fagin, she told him. She's told on all of us. Nancy.
What? Told who?
To Brownlow. She's told him everything.
What did she say?
About
what
us.
Mean everything.
About this. About the boys. About you.
Did she
about
say
everything.
Bill's name?
No, she never mentioned him.
Doesn't
us.
Matter. She read out on all of us. That's it.
Oh. No, you heard her. She didn't say your name. This isn't necessary. You'll regret this.
Oh, Joe, you're home. I have your stuff on the table.
I'll have time for that later.
What's wrong? You look strange.
Nancy, you were followed tonight, and every word that you said was heard.
Bill, I didn't say your name. I was just worried about the boy.
It doesn't matter. If they find Fagin, they'll find me.
No, they won't. We can run away or something.
It's too late for that now. It's a dark night, but not dark enough for what I'm about to do.
Bill, no. Bill!
Nancy, where are you? Are you upstairs?
Ah!
Oh, Nancy, I was afraid this was going to happen.
Fagin, we're in trouble. There's a mob coming and we need to get out of here. You heard the boy! Go, the bakes are coming! Wait, Charlie, Georgia, help me with Oliver! Go, you heard him! We have to get out of here before Bill comes!
Sykes is already here. Give me the boy, Fagin!
Only rid in the world of another traitor.
No, I will not let you own that boy.
I need a boss.
I'm
getting
no,
out.
No, you're mad, man, Bill. You're mad, man. No.
Get away or the boy dies.
Let him go.
I got these two.
No, wait. They should be pardoned.
But they're criminals.
They saved Oliver's life.
I suppose so. But I'll catch up to you boys later.
No!
Off to the gallows to you.
No, I'm a good man!
Oliver, I'm sorry for misjudging you. Will you please accept my apology?
You sure?
Oliver, is there something troubling you?
Well, I never really got a chance to say goodbye to Fagin, and tomorrow he's gonna be hanged, so...
Well, I can't arrange a visit, if that's really what you want.
Yes, please.
Oliver, are you sure you want to do this?
Yes, sir. It's the right thing to do.
The boy would like to see Fagin.
He's acting kind of crazy. You have 2 minutes. Hey, Fagin, you have a visitor. It's probably your last one before you swing.
Oliver, that's you, isn't it? Is that really you?
Yes, sir, it is. I thought it'd be okay if I went to see you one last time, since you were so good to me.
Tell them how good I was to you. Tell them that I didn't do anything. Tell them that it was all Sykes. It wasn't me. I never laid a hand on you. I never hurt you. I was so good to the boys. You know I was.
Come along, Oliver. It's time to go.
No! Tell them how good I was. Tell them how I never hurt you. Tell them that I cared for the boys. How great I was.
I'll pray for you, Fagin.
No! Tell them! Tell them! You know I didn't do anything. I'm innocent.
It's time, Fagin.
No! 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 I will not go! I will not go to the gallows! I'm innocent! I'm a good man! I'm a good man! I didn't do anything! Ask Oliver! I'm innocent! Oliver will tell you! I'm a good man! I'm a good man! I'm innocent! I'm innocent! I'm a good man! Oliver will tell you! No, I'm a good man. Really, I'm not like the others. I'm not like them.